An insulated piston cylinder device initially contains 260 liters of air at 149 kilopascals and 17 degrees Celsius. The air is now heated for 20 minutes by a 160 watt resistance heater placed inside the cylinder. The pressure of air is maintained constant during this process. Determine the entropy change of air assuming constant specific heats and variable specific heats. As usual, try pausing here to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the reference entropy and specific heats main lecture. The link to that 12-minute lecture and all the other examples and lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. If using the exact analysis, which is the variable specific heats option, the entropy change is given by this expression in terms of the reference entropy and pressure values. If using the inexact analysis or constant specific heats, the entropy change is given by this expression in terms of CP and pressures. And we go with this one here instead of the CV and the volumes version, because since the pressure is maintained constant, the pressure term is going to be zero. And this applies to the exact solution too. So for this constant pressure process, the entropy change is just the reference entropy change. For state 1, we have the temperature, so we can just look up the reference entropy for it. For state 2, we first need to fully define it. We know that the energy that we put into a system of a constant pressure process is equal to the enthalpy change. Therefore, the wattage times the time in seconds is equal to the energy provided and also equal to the change in enthalpy. So to solve for H2, we need to look up the enthalpy for T1, which is H1, and also calculate the mass. To calculate the mass, we can use the ideal gas equation. We substitute the values and find M, and with it, we can find the specific enthalpy of state 2, H2. And with this value, we can look it up in the tables for air to find the reference entropy at state 2. Since H2 is 702.65 and there's a 702.52 value in the table, we'll just go with the reference entropy value for it, 2.55731 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. We substitute the mass and the two reference entropy values, and we find the change in entropy. For the inexact approach, we can write the change in enthalpy as Cp times the change in temperature. In this case, we are solving for T2, and the Cp value we use would have to be an estimate. Of course, we just solved this problem using the exact approach, so we know what the final temperature is. But T2 is exactly what we're trying to find here, so we would probably go with a Cp at 300 Kelvin as an approximation. We look up that value for air at 300 Kelvin, we substitute the values with T1 in Kelvin, and find T2 in Kelvin. Now we go back to our original expression and we use this same Cp value, substitute the mass and temperatures, and find the change in entropy. If you want to check out other examples for the reference entropy and specific heats topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. There, you'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermodynamics course, as well as playlists to other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!